longer the round goes on, the more comfortable the CTs will become. The bottom B control and the rotations back over to A. Pop coming up here for G2.
Flashbang top mid. That gets Keto checking corners down at the base of the ramp, but it's Tabzin who seems to shut things down pretty quickly. He was, of course, playing as that arch rotate. There's still the man inside of the pit. The other two A players now joined by that late lurk, but it's all headshots coming out of big. Three USP kills for the round as big take first pistol. 40 seconds left over, and we're starting to see G2 explore at the top of banana with bomb, and now they're just gonna go ahead and go off of this. It's towards mid that AmaNEk catches not one, but two CTs. That draws the arch rotate back in, but Mohan, it also draws the bomb over. Those two kills at the A site is enough for G2 to justify the commitment, but that's where the CTs still are. They took two off of the four-man stack. Luckily, they are able to bring it back, despite it looking like big were going to rob them. Keto is barely alive at the end of this. Greatly done by AmaNEk. Those two kills in mid.
Bomb goes down, goes off. Two AKs saved. Keto with the one rifle over a B is not so bad for Big Clan.
Now it's yet again AK up top of the site and Searson to try and draw attention into the corner. Puts the scope up, misses the first shot, misses the second. Keto's here on damage control, and he's doing an excellent job. That's a crucial three-piece coming out of Keto this round. And then further damage added to the tally versus Hunter, but he'll get his bomb plant. And a smoke grenade, and a Molotov. And now we're seeing G2 play that utility to create comfort the same way those CTs did as they backed up off Banana. But Banana now belongs to Tabzin. And with this Deagle and MP7, that is a very real threat. Kenny S on full HP, makes contact, drops Tabzin. Tizian's Deagle answers back through the edge of the wall, and Kenny goes down to Xanteres. So 2.5 rifles is enough.
And then got sprayed down. So with a little bit more utility, you might have seen a different outcome. Overall, the starts of these rounds have been good. They've been getting the rotates they want, but the opening kill keeps going to big.
Yeah, this time times two. Searson taking the duel with the man downrange. No, no, that's big. Making the offensive. Kenny S catching Tabzin on the side of double box. That could have been the kill back for G2. He will clean it up, finish it off. Jax honing in on pit is bested by Xanteres, who now has this line through the smoke grenades to ensure nobody actually crosses towards site. So they cross back instead to arch. And that's allowed to them because Keto's flank down mid didn't actually hold this. Now they know exactly where G2 can get off to, and they put that pressure on Searson, who's looking to double his kills to close this round and give Big their fifth. The T's nearly lining up as Searson isolates the duel, leaving Kenny to trade it. This is him in a 1v4 with a single defender towards B, but the smoke grenade trying to draw them into him. He gets called out and spotted, dealt with swiftly. Big lead 5-1.
At this point, we're crossing the minute mark with control at both brackets and top B, so I think they're going to be comfortable once again.
Yeah, I like the way they just kind of crank the tempo too. G2, they know what they want. It's a matter of getting it. And Kenny S gets what he wants. Two AKs on that B site. Jax trying to cut off the rotates here. Just dives back into cover.
Because they've don't get ahead of yourself. You won one round. They're going to spot one. Jax goes down. It's like, do you need to? I mean, they're going to have three rifles. A high chance they get at least one kill there.
So he just tucks into oranges and hopes that he can do the damage. There are two players tagged, make it three, one of which now down. This retake's doable, but Big last time didn't want to run the risk. It seems here, in the ninth round, they're going to take a chance. One frag, thrown out by Tabzin. Misses the mark. That could have killed either Kenny or Jax. Hell, a single stray shot would take one of them out. We get this eventual come-up banana from Tizian, but it is the site players making way more noise, and Jax, even low HP, like Kenny S, is able to get an additional kill, but there's two back for Big. It's all on AmaNEk. He pops up from the little hole and wrecks face, denying Big the retake and giving G2 a third round.
To reinforce with the op, I like this adjustment a lot, but they are still hoping it's A in event.
Oh. AmaNEk comes around as the smoke pops, and Keto barrels outwards, sees a lot of presence here. Tabzin, he's ready, boosted it up, and it's all so easy when Kenny S and Jax seem to be joined at the hip. Hunter with the second kill in the round. The only man to connect the kills is shut down by Searson.
Yeah, they lose a couple of players in that process. And there was that weird moment where Big were trying to get the off, but then rotate out. However, there's Eco. You can't write it off. AmaNEk gets an opening Tech 9 kill, and Zantaris is only here by himself, trying to do the best that he can. He's almost in safety, but AmaNEk gets another kill.
Damn, if that bomb was able to...
Zantaris has cleared mid and dinked his teammate.
Oh, and then Kenny S gets a second on it. Is this good? It was looking like a five-man survive type G2 moment off of the Tech 9s. Okay, let's settle down. I think everybody was kind of lulled into this false sense of security. The rounds had been playing out quite textbook. You know, we had utility being exchanged down banana. Everybody was sizing one another up. Nobody was doing anything too crazy. And then AmaNEk, out of nowhere, running through middle, insta headshots the mid peak. That's a wrench in the works. And look at the result of this as well.
Oh my god. Yeah, swing round.
Wow. Blink and you'll miss it. A slap in the face coming from G2. Now everybody's woke. But Big are also broke. An MQ9 on Zantara is all they had. Emphasis on the past tense, because already two kills coming in for G2. Make it a third. Tabson's inside of the smoke throwing utility, but the only B defense is Big's last remaining members. Tabson loses Keto, tries to flash himself outwards, but that's five guys up for G2, now only one round away, and Big, they're in recovery mode. Pressure arch through the Molotov costs them a lot of HP, but they do get the trade frag. Now we're going to get Searson in the back of the bomb site with that off. Not the most comfortable position for a sniper to be, but with Zantarez on his side, suddenly things seem easy. Kenny S will trade one. Hunter snapping the headshot into Searson brings us to the 2v2. Bomb retrieve for only a moment. 6 seconds left over. Hunter needs to plant. He thinks the CT's close and that he can get the kill, but that's not the case. This half fizzles out, not with a frag, but rather the clock.
Oh man.
It's okay, that's over already for Keto.
A good guy to kill, man. Keto's had some monster energy. Okay, this first half. Oh, he's gone. They don't have to worry about him. Ooh.
Nice. Kenny, yes. Taps into the face of Tabson. But they have alleviated the pressure on Arch. This now allows Big to play around with the idea of the wrap, but with a man in apps. They want to hit this A site. Check out the radar. CT's kind of sniffing out and suspecting all situations. Zantarez, he's going to work into the bomb site. The corners are clear, my friend. It's really just the pit you have to worry about. Because of that moment of silence they took towards Arch side, G2 actually doubled a couple players over towards B. And that's what allowed for them to now exit. Kenny S, he just comes quickly into the retake. His 13th frag as he swoops into the pit and leaves this on Searson 1v4. All the T's hit the floor and G2 tie at 8. Am I crazy or are there just more and more M4A1S players kind of popping out of the woodworks here? We got two for the moment on G2. And one of which got a single kill on the hold. Only a single kill. Kenny S through the smoke, trying to connect one. Once that smoke fades, maybe G2 try and throw this one. Oh my god, they're taking so much damage from the fire. The bomb, it's already halfway gone, but AmaNEk does have positioning inside of the site. Zantarez sees him, and they just have to play the clock. Kenny S gets the headshot, but they're gone. And now they realize that it's difficult to retreat. Kenny S could have also survived with his two teammates, but that is not the case. Bomb pops, and even Nexa dies. Instead, they're gonna move that bomb over towards Arch. And with a flashbang and a smoke and a frag going through it, Tabson realizes, I may have made a mistake, a grave error. He has delivered bomb to the library. Oh no, things go from bad to worse unless Tizian can just pick up all of the pieces. AmaNEk's low HP, but Jax goes for the peak. 5 health left on Tizian. 2 CTs to try and topple. Frag grenade could blow AmaNEk into tomorrow. Shebang! And suddenly, it's the 1v1. What if Jax starts doubting himself?
He's scared. Yeah, he's scared.
Things are getting, because Jax doesn't have armor either, right? So let's say first bullet hits him. Tizian suddenly has an aim punch. He's on the doorway. He's walking in. Jax is spotted and closes this round. Oh boy. He hits a shot despite being splashed. Kenny S repositions quickly over towards Coffins. There's no second smoke. He reads into Keto, going around, and AmaNEk even catching Tizian down middle after he was able to get one kill. So it's a 4v3 with bomb planted. There's going to be a very crucial fight going down on Banana, though. Big time. It's a 2v2 on that side of the map, trading efficiently so far. The edge still for G2, but now it's taken away. Nexa is all that's left over, and a smoke grenade meets him on this cross. If he walks through it, it's desperate. Xantera is unable to stop him, and Nexa clutching out of nowhere.
They've got enough for a very tiny execute. There's the God Flash. But can you flash
any
a God?
Yeah, exactly, right? AmaNEk, he's fine back here on New Box. Kenny's going to keep the pressure up with the shots, with the flashbangs, bombs dropped in construction, big. It's going to be hard to come get it, but Xanteres will rail Kenny between the eyes with the Deeg. AmaNEk's smoke starting to fade, but he's fine. It's actually just Xanteres who's been a nuisance this time around. Looking for more. Xanteres, 3 frags off of this Desert Eagle. I mean, you wanted to talk about gods. This is one right here. 15 seconds left over, but he faces a very difficult crossfire. However, they are going to give him a chance at this. The second player is not peeking due to his 5 HP. And even then, Xanteras, too many angles to check. Big winners. Not like a team that got reverse swept by Big in the grand finals of DreamHack Masters. No, sir. And that's the Big, or rather the G2 they don't want to be. But check your corner on Banana, because you've got a pressured situation for AmaNEk, and he's got 2 kills, looking for the third, swapping to the Deeg, and slapping Searson down. Xanteres gets nothing from his arch play. G2 Esports, 14 rounds to 10. Walking up on apps. All right, let's try the pit pop. Remember, G2, they caught an A defense off guard once upon a time in the first half. Now it's Xanteres with that AK. He gets legged as he falls, Keto, but still stands. And it works. An explosive exit out from apartments gives Big a bomb plant and puts G2 into a position where they definitely have to consider a save. One player is already safe enough, I believe, in Xanteras, but if he gets checked...
We heard him.
Nexa hears the footsteps. There's the kill versus Keto, and good thing Xanteras is there to save it. 2 exit here for Big.
And you can fall down into quad after your first kill or second kill.
Flashbang's on point, but the crossfire is looking superior. Frag grenade's gonna dunk onto Tapson. No, it actually gets robbed away by the ledge. But Hunter, not a problem. He is just racking him up, but he does get denied by Searson's AWP. Still very difficult for Big to find any footing on this site. I mean, they've been fighting out of the smokes with flashbangs and frag grenades just overwhelming at all possible corners. Now Nexa comes out from New Boss, and they have Searson's position confirmed. It is 15 for G2, 4 map points on Big's map choice.
And because they go light in that regard, they can never kill him, basically. So now we come up to what could be the last round of the first map. Tizian, holy.
Yeah. They extinguish a Molotov to go for the double alt peak, and that gets punished, and then some. But it's on AmaNEk and Kenny S to try and bring this back. AmaNEk's got nothing to lose, really, other than his life and his gun and all his grenades, but I suppose maybe he values that.
I wonder what their next call will be. They've avoided the patrol, and this is great from G2. So even if they don't know now, they're re-aggressing top Banana, and they get a kill, man.
Oh, and that one's ballsy. Kenny has to go for the peak and give cover with AmaNEk up close. That's one thing. AmaNEk extending around the corner with nobody else having any vision or a real way to support, that's massive. And if this is the way G2 take away map one, props to them. Not shying away from the confrontation, but Hunter, half his magazine gone. Good thing Jax can snap back with the Deeg, and Nexa comes in with another. G2 with the half buy, getting what they could and making it work wonderfully. Robbing away Big's map pick. But right now, we've got the utility on Catwalk, which of course the CTs see, has nothing there. Three players out long, and a bomb working its way through the tunnels. The 1B player from Big has actually just left the bomb site. So while these kills go down on the top of mid, it's really Keto whose position is most important. He's got Kenny S challenging him in this one versus one, but he can't quite catch the kill. But Kenny S dancing around the box is dead, and Keto had a teammate to come bail him out of a very sticky situation. So what's left of G2 and Jax and AmaNEk has to retake the bomb site before the bomb is planted. So many players inside of it. This one has gone to hell.
Okay.
Not yet. Oh, and he's actually
He's getting close now. Okay.
Oh my god. Dizzy never peaked.
I want to say Nexa is usually very responsible when it comes to holding these pushes, but they're out through the molly. Trades are okay. Actually quite good. Wow, they kill everybody in the spawn. Long-range duels go badly, and finally Tizian will come barreling down mid, but he's got the short barrel of his MP9.
All right, Searson with the no-scope, almost getting that peek onto the player looking the other direction, but Kenny S gives cover. I mean, this round really, it's that 3K from Hunter that really got them into the B bomb site and whatnot. Sure, Searson, he gets the tip of the hat for the no-scope in the end of it, but it is G2 Esports on the board. The Blue Spruce.
Blue Spruce, yeah. Dr. Seuss.
Very lame.
Blue Spruce.
Yeah, somebody get this man something hot.
My favorite would be the Blood of the Water. But wait a second. Hunter gets that kill, and it's two players with some utility, good weapons, versus Tabson, who's low. However, body shot Deagle is good. 1v2 now, and he got an extra hit off onto Hunter.
Yes, he did. Ooh, there it is, though. Headshot versus Keto. I mean, Keto had the chance. You heard the bullet zinging by Hunter, and on 50 HP. Yep, Xanteras. Oh, gets called out. Hunter is on wild. Three kills last round, four frags this time. This is the way to play it, boys. You've got Tabson on the bomb site with his M4. Searson, ready as ever, soaked in. Flash indicates the hit, and Searson nails it. But it is a quick trade from AmaNEk MAC-10, of all things. Poor sniper couldn't get out of danger's way. Tizian from long A ducks back behind cover as the B rotates do arrive, and they want to get into position before the T's can actually sneak back onto Cat. There's Hunter popping up on the edge of the smoke. Doesn't seem like Xantera's saw him, but Tizian's into the equation with two kills already. Has to get the reload and will. Then faces Hunter on catwalk, and that's Hunter's 10th kill. His third big multi-kill. Here comes the flashbangs. Keto's able to weather the first storm. Easy second peek up. Anybody else want to give him a shoulder? Or are you going to use Kenny S's entry on CT to try and get out of dodge? Here's Tizian from the top of mid, finds great timing and a nice bit of rifle control to transition into the head of AmaNEk. Nexa's in the clutch. Unfortunately for him, already half HP.
He can go Cat and have a shallow angle to shoot it from. And oh my god, they heard this, didn't they?
No. He didn't. Oh my god, he lines up. Oh, what could have been?
Well, why doesn't G2 mid to be here? That's my question. Oh, there you go.
Here's your answer. But Keto's got the response. Two kills with the op. Kenny will stop him before he nails a third, but then he also anticipates the CT peak. There's somebody else back there. Ah, 7 seconds. Searson waiting just long enough. Jax, unable to clear the site fast enough, dies as Xanteras shoots him in the backside. It's a fourth round for Big.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's like three kills. They will put the smoke down and Searson's attention's on it. Easy pickup versus Jack, but now those flashes cause a bit of an issue, or do they? Not for Big, that is. Tizian, two easy kills, and Searson gets his double. So the long lockdown works out wonderfully. They've got the bomb over there in full control, so be it if Hunter has the B site. He didn't hold on to it very long. Xanteras ties this game up.
Okay, boys, group and explode, 3v4. Give it our best shot. 25 seconds left. Unless they're going to save now, which it doesn't seem like they're going to do. They're actually attempting a fake with poor AmaNEk on red HP. Hunter looking up for the entry, is falling on the ramp, and he's sure to get off. Keto's there, in fact, to get another couple. Very nice map from Keto so far from losing that map. And now, yeah, this Fierce and Tizian combo is huge. Ooh. Kenny S, oh my God, oh. He just hit three op shots in a row. Fierceon goes down after two. And now we're starting off with a more fiery tempo.
Everybody's dead. Everybody's already almost dead, man. Kenny S shooting three bullets, one of which was a collateral. Tizian looking to survive here. Hunter's giving chase. That's him done. Or not. Two kills with him. Okay. Okay. I thought the flashbang was going to be enough, but he... Kenny S finds no early damage at the start of this one, and it's a hyper aggression from Searson. Called out. Kenny's called out. He tried to walk down suicide, and Searson grants him the gift of death. A 5v4 here turned 5v3. Again, it's the snipers. If they're not dying while they overface Kenny S in mid, they are doing wonders of curbing off the body count from G2. Keto also down tunnels, gets himself another. It's a 2v5 attempt for G2 to close out their T half, and it all comes to an abrupt halt because of Keto and Xanteres. 9-6 for Big. Yep. And it just seems a little bit too much to handle in that first 15. But we are very quickly into an offensive from G2. They've got Hunter down in the lower tunnels with two CTs fighting top mid. Hunter finds a bit of success, but he needs to lend a helping hand at the top of middle because one of those two players is dead. Kenny can't quite catch it. And Nexa from inside of the double doors. Oh, he is all that's left over. Big about to grab their double digits. Try to get some big stocks. Hey, anybody got some big stocks here? I'm from New York in the 1960s. You got some big stocks? I got small stocks, medium stocks, but no big stocks. How about some trades? I'm looking for trades. I'm looking for work. I want to do something for me. Let you help me make this happen. Nexa, 26 HP, not much left here. I mean, the facing him, the bomb's halfway gone. What's he gonna do about it? Number two pencils only. Kenny S drops the flashbang. He hears that offshot zing by. Xanteres actually gets it while somewhat blind, and then Tabson follows with an additional kill. This is quite wild, but there's 24 HP left for Big's players combined, both of which now on snipers, both of which now down long. And it's Hunter who's going to have to try and contest this on his own.
He hears one run the pit. So this might give him a weird...
No, Tabson.
Oh, what happens?
Vital
wow, that
error.
Patience from Hunter. Oh my God.
Yeah, just sat there, waited. Tabson pulls his knife out, wanted to wrap back around Cat. Xanteres is in pit, knowing there's a player close. AmaNEk sticking the defuse through the smoke. Of course, he doesn't have a kit, so if he comes off it, there's no chance at the win, but Xanteres, okay. He still fires back, and he's come out here for pit control. He's still looking for it. A little gap in the smoke almost cost him. Kenny was very much focused on it. Hunter to be challenged here out tunnels. The second flashbang blinds him. AmaNEk laying down the utility as well. They see the T's on the cusp of the tunnels, and AmaNEk now has cover. Difficult spot for him as three T's stacked up. A banked frag grenade that misses the mark, but again, it's teammates that are keeping Hunter so comfortably in this position. Everybody from this B bomb site has died. The only success was really Tizian elsewhere on A, and it comes to a close to the favor of G2. They now trail by four. They're going to try with just their Glocks and Deagle to get out tunnels. AmaNEk pops up, sees a bunch of bodies. He's hiding and hoping that Searson can't close him, but AmaNEk doing a good job back and forth with Hunter's help. His now 23rd frag of this second map. Utility goes down deep on Cat. Kenny S still in the middle of it all, but these T's are so close to rounding the corner. And I mean, he is standing on full display. Now with the smokes down, he is honed in. Nice flick.
Holy,
a second from Kenny, a third. Phenomenal hold coming out of Kenny S. Tizian's able to answer as he spams through smoke for the second into Hunter. We're left with the two versus two. Xanteres separate from Nexa on Cat with a crisp headshot, puts it on AmaNEk. Not his best map as he sits at a dilapidated 8-17, bombs gone down. Kenny S surging the server with an electrifying 3K. Is it enough for AmaNEk to close? He is standing on Tizian. He finds him, shot to the back of the head. He knows where Xanteres is at. A single flash is all he has. He gets on the bomb and he loses the duel. It's Big to find 14.
That was so close, man, but
just Jax. Ooh, insta dink. Good early damage. No kills. No, we were looking for the frags. The damage is there. It's across the board versus big, but this is 6 map points to extend the series to overpass. Tabson's got that bomb. He learned his lesson on Inferno, so he'll walk away with it. Keto, he drops off of catwalk, besting Kenny S. That's one of the two hard hitters taken out of this 25th round. We're even at the 3v3. Hunter tries to activate. He saw the trajectory of the smoke over mid, telling him Xanteras was still towards spawn, and there is a player in Goose in the form of Nexa. Sure, 5 frags across this map, but for him to get 2 right now would be massive. And yes, he will close alongside Hunter.
Yeah, it was very messy. V2 would just be happy to get that one over with, move on to the next.
Pressure out long A. Whoa, whoa. Hyper aggression. Tabson just facing through smoke, but it does set up Xanteras. He is the AK player. Other pistolman out from catwalk, but now it's Xanteras sectioned off. Unable to make the most of that cat distraction. Tizian does have a CT in an awkward position, but he can't quite find him. He will eventually get there, but so will G2. And that's all they needed. That's the bomb plant with 2 players on cat and 2 positioned on long. Oh, what? Nexa just blows him away off of the car. The flashbang's great. Trades back the other way. 3v2 here for big. They've got Nexa creeping up from CT spawn. And Jax, he's mollied off for the time being. Keto's looking ready to go because Jax is all that's left over. And big still looking like the kings of dust too. G2 may have robbed the crown from Astralis, but big are now holding onto it. Jax looking to get into this bomb site, moving inwards, sees the player on long and dies to Tabson's AK. That's it. 3 maps needed. A justified pick from big. The head-to-head still flawless between them and G2 on Dust 2. But it's down in Connector, in the doldrums, where things might get weird. AmaNEk and Hunter trying to play a little diagonal crossfire, and Xanteras and Keto just not playing games. Nope.
Uh-oh.
Trolls in the dungeon. Another and then, of course, trying to recover something from the round. They get aggressive. Nexa moves forward with Kenny. They catch Kenny, but they don't find Nexa. Nexa,
yikes.
Oh, that gotta hurt.
He had a bad map on Dust 2, man. Very bad map. I say that with love, because Nexa has been like their IGL and their star fragger.
That's like the Iron Dome defense system. Hunter peeks over the wall, boom, nade to the face. Thinks about going again, oh, another nade. And now, the push. Big already committing to this B site. They've got 2 kills before Kenny S and Jax answer back. And there's further damage being done. Look at Tizian and Searson, they're barely alive. This MAC-10 is not quite what Searson would hope for. Let's see if Keto with the bomb and the AK can just put everything to rest. Taps into the head of Kenny, sees the other two, and even he can't manage. Searson needs 1 shot each, but Jax rails him with the deagle, and G2 robbed the round. Getting dangerously close, but AmaNEk, a bit of a connoisseur, these bathrooms positions, always on something special. Look at this. Playing around the edge of the smoke. That is nasty. They barely even saw him. Kenny S at a distance with the M4A1S Knight. Now that is an argument for the better skins, Launders. But you didn't mention that one, so your argument is void.
Which one?
Searson now walking in with the scout. The Knight. It's from the Cobblestone Collection. Goodbye.
Is it on the ground?
It just doesn't have the same punchline.
True.
But throwing
that.
Punches is big at the B site. Ready to come through monster. Threw a Molotov again. Not fearful of fire or frags because they have fury in Xanteras. He gets through Nexa and Jax as they're just offloading their utility belts like Batman. Xanteras comes swinging out with his superpower. Aim. Hunter jumps to the top of the site trying to catch T's within it. And they don't know he's here. They're trying to sniff him out, but he goes over the top of it as Xanteras finds yet another kill. It's Hunter to finally answer, but he is bested. It's only AmaNEk from the heavens above. 6th round. Of course, trailing by 1, but well-equipped.
Hey, there's a chance here for G2 to actually hold on to this round.
Yeah, if Big don't hard clear this tightest of corners, There is a chance he is able to catch Xantera's, not Tizian. Two kills, then that third one comes back from Hunter. Oh, Hunter! Two headshots off the M4A1S. A perfect call from AmaNEk to tuck into the corner.
That's what you get for doing too good of a job.
And he has his big flank here up through the ladder room. Oh, gets cut stuff. He pulls out the knife. He wants the money. Oh, he wanted the money. Lawnmower.
Oh, that's him. Yeah, that's the lawnmower right in front of him. Yes, in the game.
So it's just going to be a bit of a clash inside of this bomb site. Now remember, Kenny S picks up that op from Long A. He just got a headshot into Tabson as Nexa gets one with the USP. Did you see Kenny's shot from his perspective? Because you just screamed like you did.
Into the middle of the box from heaven.
Gunner, we need the replay. And the round's not yet over. Kenny's been boosted up. He's doing further damage. This picked up op. I see why he risked it last round. Because once Kenny's got the magic stick. Oh, the fireworks, baby. The flank, though, from Monster. That's going to be good as Nexa bests Keto Tizian. His main gun's dry, so it's just the Glock. But none of these players have actual armor, so he could still line up these headshots. He could very well deny this. It's on the burst. He even gets the second. But Kenny S, play three it. Kills for him, gives G2 his sixth. Okay, Deagle, boom.
Before he gets the op to do that. Woo! It has to go between the two stacks of the... Okay, top bathrooms. AmaNEk, can he be trusted? He's getting flanked, but it doesn't matter. He's got Keto, and he'll have a smoke as well to create some cover. He's been good by himself. Been very kind of reliable to play bathrooms alone. Kenny just grabs another, man. He has got 16 kills.
He's crazy. Yeah, Kenny's going big on this one. He wants the series. And Hunter, well, trying to get back up to par. Remember, it was very much the Kenny S and Hunter show on Dust 2 to even make that map anywhere near close. And right now, Kenny's keeping up the tempo. Searson, 1v5. Four of the five players from G2 damaged, but none of which dead. G2 are running upwards, throwing flashes, trying to stave off the execute and the commitment here from Big, but they will go for it. Bomb planted behind Dice. Tizian's throwing away ops. Okay, I was going to say settle down. But he actually now scopes in on it. He's down to 6 HP. Two snipers in the post plant, and he's pushed off by that pressure.
Can't really escape bank here. No nades for Hunter to get out. He'll have to just run across or something.
Searson's ready. Finds the timing on the peak as those two CTs got ever closer. And there's another one from Searson. Great post plant. Hunter knows he has no business in this. He'll get the fadeaway headshot into Tizian and call it quits. A fourth round for Big. Molly hits his mark, pushes him back somewhat. Still, he sticks around. And so have Big. Minute on the clock. They could walk away from this, but the utility is doing a good job of delaying, except a boost behind APC was not seen by Big until it was too late. Kenny S trying to get the wall bang, actually just hit Searson, but not hard enough. Hunter off the side of Dumpster loses his head to Xantera's, and Kenny S just saw him in the open, goes for the peak, finds himself in the middle of Searson's scope. Back-to-back rounds where Searson bests Kenny.
So they're going to push Monster off of this information, and Xantera's going to be there to hold. He does some good damage, gets away with a kill, and now AmaNEk 5-7. Wow. He'll have to have one of his best 5-7 days ever to stop this long presence, but they're kind of spread thin. There's one close up in Tabson, and Tizian is quite far back. Good flash from Tizian to make sure that he doesn't have to have a fair fight, and that leaves Kenny S all alone. 1v4, Kenny S.
I mean, there will definitely be eyes in heaven knowing that Kenny's the last man alive. Smoke lands in front of him. He goes barreling out, hits the water. They are all very close, and Xantera's wastes no time. A 3K, don't beat yourself up. It's Kenny S's job. He's beating everybody up this map. 20 freaking frags by the end of that first half, and this one's already quickly underway. We got Keto playing games in the playground. King of the hill pushes AmaNEk down into the dirt, kicks sand in his eyes. Where's your mama now? And 4v3 to Big's favor here. Looking to tie things up early at 8. I mean, how do you get out a connector when there's already counter terrorists on Fountain? You can't. The answer is you can't. You have to go back to the B site, which is exactly what G2 will try to do. But you know who else is really good other than Kenny S? Xanteres. Man's got almost as many frags in just the amount of the same amount of rounds. Oh my goodness. Ooh. Look at Keto, just like the last round. Just, dude, these flashbangs. I don't even know if G2 realized this man's dead yet. Xanteres will trade as he followed suit and Tabson. No, excuse me, it's Tabson's trade. That's the big one. Low HP, man. I mean, this round right here, right? This is a crucial one. Let's be real. Okay, jokes aside, wrap it in a business package, put a tie on it. This was a huge round with guns on each side, and Big didn't even care. They go running out, Monster. And I mean, two players on such minimal health, that was massive. That was their chance where things could have gone the absolute opposite way. And it could have been recovered by Kenny, but he was so stuck between Searson and Tabson, he had nowhere to run.
He hated it. So that's how you know he really hates it.
Oh, Nexa almost fell for the trap of going for the closer kill, but he still got his headshot when he needed to. Big looking for that 11th round. And well, Jax is doing a good job of making him fight for it. Keep your eye on the radar. As all of these kills come in from Jax, the bomb is heading towards B. And the bomb may not even be needed if they could continue with kills. But Jax,
it gets
back in
a bit.
Bank.
They know Jax is on A, right? So this is the hard part. They can rush down AmaNEk. And now what's Jax to do?
Yeah. He's going to run in. Audio's being heard. Xanteres is going to try to stick this. If he can hit him with the wall bang. If he can hit him with the wall bang right now, that would have been the stoppage. But,
What?
He got it just in time. Oh, my God. There's no kit on Keto. He's going to run in and get on it. Should have time. We're all good. Defuse comes
messy.
Through.
That was one of those swing trade moments. If Hunter gets his Tech 9 kill in the CT spawn guy, which he probably should have, then that's a round over. So, big three-round lead. Searson opening off frag on Kenny S, no less.
Damn. They do not need Kenny S to cool off right now. Him getting beat by Searson in that first off duel of this second half, that's massive, and now it's just going to go from bad to worse. Tabson and Tizian picking up kills all over the place. If Xanteres closes this one from down Monster, it's a team ace. Put a ribbon on it, ship it off. Boom. One frag apiece. Okay, here's another chance. Doesn't feature the yawp on Kenny, which is how he got this crazy of a stat line, but oh, Tabson peeking underneath the crosshair there of Hunter. Nexa, he's got to trade this, and he can't. Tabson wide swings back out. The kill feed is full of blue to the favor of Big. This 13th round about to be added to the tally because it's just frag after frag. AmaNEk's gonna try his damnedest here. Second kill in the round, minute on the clock, bomb on his back, but 15 health to work with spells disaster.
Gonna go for the Jordan nothing Gilbert flank. Oh, actually, back to stairs. Never mind. This goes Paper Mario down the ladder and dies.
Oh man! And if Tabson draws their attention at the, like right before he peeks, yeah, easy for Searson. He's gonna extend into it, gets the second kill. Then Tabson hits them just a moment after. Sure, Searson. Oh, he peeled back for a moment. That is impeccable. The two-pronged pinch completely obliterates G2 and Mohan. That was their gun round. That's what they were waiting to get into.
Like something substantial at the level of a DreamHack Masters or, well, hold on. There's going to be a rush outside to Monster. A great flick to kick things off for Searson. Malia spot, DT's to help. Oh,
Searson with another one. Kenny's up close. He will get Tabson at least, but then Xanteres clotheslines him out of it. Nexa, he's got to come alive here and now. He gets the second kill versus Searson. It's him and Keto locking horns, and Nexa pierces through with all three of those players. It's better late than never. Flip that coin and see what's going on, because that was such a hot start, but it has fizzled out. in the face of Big's consistency across the scoreboard. Searson on the scope, unscopes at the worst possible moment. Xanteras can trade with Tizian by him. That Molotov is what made the difference. Hunter creeps in. He gets the back of Tizian and finding Xanteras mid-transition. Can't quite jump down onto the sniper. Searson with the no scope pushes Nexa into back-to-back clutches. He faces two snipers, and that's all they need. A headshot comes out of Keto as Big win the series 2-1 on Overpass.
Searson ends on 29. Hard-fought series, a lot more decisive on CT side of Overpass.